The VOD is gonna be really funny. We're just staring at the screen for the 8 minutes. but we got comments on the last video saying like, oh no, you should keep it in there because like there's context on like how you reacted. Sure, I remember in the preview, the 28-second preview of this very short. I saw a comment of like, I'm sorry, I'm new to the game. Who is Murata Himeko and what, like, why is like everyone, you know, so attached to her? And then all the replies were like, oh, prepare your tissues. Like, oh, you're in for tears. Like, oh, you're gonna, you know, it's gonna get dark. And like, people spamming replies on that guy. So I guess you do know most of the story up till this point.
Yes.
But, should I do like a catch up first? I guess people like watching this.
Major spoiler alert. But if you're already watching the video, then you're probably already in a way spoiled because the video basically gives away a lot of the plot, jumps
like two chapters from where we are. But we did a playthrough. I did a 6-hour stream just to catch up.
Wow.
The first hour was mainly just the Genshin X, Honkai X Genshin. And then after we moved over to CN to do like chapter 25. So we did a full playthrough of like 16 story stages. Basically, the gist of it is that they're now in the Theater of Domination. They went back in, and then Kiana had to face Siren. And then there's so much information about like Hyasha's and how the cores work.
To the imaginary realm.
Not really to the imaginary realm, but like the cores in general. And Siren and like Kiana had to fight for control over like the power, like who the gems chose to be like giving power to. Fu Hua had to do that as well. Bronya is also regaining her Hyasha of Reason powers because when Fu Hua wrestled power from Sentience and she used Sentience's power, the Hyasha of Domination stole it. And then but Mei on the other side is like weakening the Hyasha because she's on like a fight, maybe I think with like the main body. That's why he's weakening like everything in the domain. So,
okay.
So Bronya said she could feel the core regaining its power. So I think in that sense, Fu Hua should be regaining some of Sentience's power as well. So during the stream, I was like super excited to be like, oh my god, will there be like that kind of like anime moment where there's a last minute save where Sentience comes in and like is like asks Fu Hua, like, hey, you miss me? Oh my god. But they already spoke in the story because Sentience was like, oh my god, first Kevin's goons and then some weird dolls and then now you know, something like that. So they already spoke when Fu Hua tried to borrow some power. But I'm wondering if like Sentience will come back and like, oh, miss me? Like, you need my help again? You know, kind of thing. Like, oh, things can't be done without me around. Kind of that kind of that's how she always behaves, right? So I'm really excited. Like, I really don't know what to expect out of this. It's at the moment when we're at this video, there's only like 384 views. I'm sure by the time we're done, it's gonna be like 30k in those 8 minutes, or like 100k even, because so many people are looking forward to this. So we'll leave captions on and let's get this show on the road.
Shit. Thank you.
That was a lot. That was a lot to take in.
Yeah. I was expecting Mei to appear. But, you know, it was good. It was good. I don't know. Do you think Mei should have been there or not? Or do you think them keeping it as, like, Kiana's moment was good? Because, like, even, like, at the last attack...
I could go either way, I think. I think I could have gone either way.
Yeah.
I think it's fine as is, but, you know, if Mei did have an appearance, I would not oppose it.
Yeah, I mean...
Is Bronya and Fu Hua actually dead?
Oh. No, I don't think they're
just
dead.
Like heavily wounded.
I think they're heavily wounded.
Just heavily wounded.
Yeah. Because the way they lent the power, it's like their consciousness is still there. They're still there. They just couldn't like physically get up. That's all. But like they could still access their power. So I don't think they're dead. At least, like, nah. So what?
You remember during the beta test, it's like, how does she have 4 gems on her sword? Her sword's the Infinity Stone sword now.
Yeah.
Right? But at the same time, I was like, oh, okay, it's the 3 gems that Siren already had as, you know, her Shred of the Void.
So Void.
And that was my initial
gem of haste.
That was what I initially thought.
And wait, Serenity is the Dihasha Void's own gem, right?
I believe so.
The Gem of Haste is the Hashel Fires. It's actually just a fragment of a gem, I think is what they said. And then, one more that she had, I can't remember, Gem of something. It's, Wendy's.
Conquest. It shows up on the buff list when you're fighting HOV. You remember.
Yeah, it's Conquest, oh, yeah. but I just don't... Where did it come from? It was Wendy's, right? I don't remember.
I think it was Wendy's, yeah, because she gets it back...
Those were the three gems that we thought were in the sword, but apparently it's not. It's Reason, Sentiences, Flames, and Voids. Wait.
Which makes sense.
Okay, yeah. There's just so much in there. Also, I'm glad that at the attack, they had Theresa in there. There was so much talk about her in the story.
Wait. Can you show that? Was there a clip with Theresa?
Yeah.
Oh, wait. No. Go back.
Let me just... Yeah. Because we're gonna replay, like, very...
Oh, Theresa is there. And Mei. So Mei was there.
Oh, Mei was there.
It's just like a glimpse.
Because it's red. Like, oh. Okay.
Yeah, she blends in, but she's there.
Oh, this scene...
It's so cute that they have Theresa. You can miss that.
I immediately saw Theresa because in the playthrough of the story, Himeko kept mentioning them all by name. She's like, every time she would talk about, like, sometimes she would say, oh, the people at Saint Freya, but like, every time she would just be like, oh, and there's a lot of talk about, like, now that I'm gone, Theresa is the only one that will be taking care of you, like, taking care of you guys. So don't be, like, don't give her any trouble. So there was always, like, Himeko kept saying that. And then, she said things, like, specifically about everyone. So she said, she thinks Bronya will grow into being, like, a very, brilliant instructor. So maybe it's, like, foreshadowing, right? Like, maybe in the future APHO episodes, we'll see, like, Bronya out, like, as an instructor. And then she said about Fu Hua, the stuff she said about Fu Hua is like, we didn't spend that much time together, you know, it's like, she really appreciated Fu Hua as a friend kind of thing. And then like, because it was Kiana telling Himeko everything that happened after Will of the Hasha, because like, to him, in Himeko's memory, that was yesterday. And then, so she wouldn't know what happened all the way until now. She found out about like, oh, Fu Hua's like 50,000 years old and everything. And she was like, oh, you know, she just gave her comments on that. And then for Mei, it was like, she said, you should trust in Mei's decision. So like, it's like she named everyone and then she talked about everyone throughout the entire story, the story stages. So Theresa also came up a lot. So when I saw that scene, immediately I was like, oh, it's really cute how they put her in there. Like just visually how cute it looks. I mean, okay, so Mei is in there. Huh. Mei is still conscious, though, in the story. So, okay, to give a bit of context, and also, like, when I was fighting against this boss in the story, chat was like, oh no, new Memorial Arena boss?
Why are they worried about that when this boss could be an Abyss boss, too?
Oh yeah, it's gonna be, oh. There's, like, so many phases to it. This one. So, there's like, they're like, oh, so two phases is not enough. We're doing a three-phase boss now, kind of. But, yeah, I mean...
I know it's technically going to be imaginary type, but could you see them also making this, like, a mech type so that you could, that they would make this, like, a, you need to run Herschel Flame Scion on this fight?
I guess, okay, they could also make imaginary, but fire weather.
Oh,
that could work.
Yes.
So it's like, hey, you want imaginary? Take it, but fire weather. The VOD is going to be really funny. We're just staring at the screen for 8 minutes. but we got comments on the last video saying like, oh, no, you should keep it in there because like, there's context on like how you reacted. Sure. I don't think I mean, I kind of smiled when, like, especially when I saw Theresa, I kind of really smiled because just the graphic of that is so cute.
Yeah, I think I just got thrown off by because I get it, right? The villain is an unreliable narrator. So when the villain is saying like, oh, they're dead, I was like, wait, are they really?
But, like, okay, so touching on that, there are a lot of ways to interpret it, but I feel like the way... Okay, so this is a bit of breaking the fourth wall, right? Because I feel the way that miHoYo has presented the whole thing is like, especially in chapter 25, it's really like, goodbye Himeko.
Right.
And I think they did it the best way they could, that it's authentic, that Kiana still gets a chance to speak to Himeko, but also that she already died way back. Because there's also talk about, like, Siren kind of confirms it. So that's the only source we get. Because I also reminded chat when we were at that part of the story, I was like, so remember, I remember you specifically saying that on one of your streams that I was lurking. So I said, I remember Fen saying, just remember the context because, and then I also repeated, like, echoed that to chat because, like, the Hash of Domination is trying to mess with everyone's head who's in there, and now she's in a one-to-one conversation with Kiana. She's trying to, like, use that guilt against Kiana. So that's the context of it, right? So you can't really take her word for it. But she did say that she found a gem by itself, and it was embedded in the armor. So the armor and the wielder should be there where the gem is, but she found the gem alone, like, in the Abyss. So it's like saying that, you know, that's it. So I don't really know how to interpret that as well. But that's one of that's the first, like, talk about the gem when it first appears in the story. And then the next one is Kiana talking to Siren, because this one I think is more reliable, because Kiana was regaining consciousness when, you know, like, in the part of, like, Final Lesson when the ice shifted when Himeko was, like, midair flying away. So it's, like, it's easy to say that it's half Siren and half Kiana's consciousness when that happened. But Siren said, even you can recall, you know very well that we killed her before she dropped off the bridge. But Siren specifically said, you know well that I killed her before she dropped off the bridge. So Siren kind of confirmed that she wasn't even, like, dead just from falling off that bridge. She was already dead, like, in the short itself. I feel like that's enough confirmation because Siren dies after. Spoiler. Like, in the story. Like, Siren in the story, like, is also gone for good. So it's like, you know, dying words is, like, admissible in court kind of thing. So it's like, Siren has no reason to be lying to Kiana at that point. She's like, right. You're just running away. You're not accepting it. But you and I know what happened. So it's like full confirmation. That line alone is enough to confirm it for me. And then,
yeah.
Because I was gonna say, they acquired the Gem of Haste. So Kiana does a really Chad move in the story. Siren wrestles the power of the Hyasha core of the Hyasha of the Void away from Kiana. So because they're fighting in their own subconscious, right? So like whoever has more power from the gem is able to control the domain that they're in. And then Kiana keeps losing power from it. And then Siren tries to kill her like when she's fully powered by the core of the Hyasha of the Void. And then Kiana is able to like respond with a Hyasha's power. And then Siren was like, oh, you're drawing power from the Gem of Haste. So it's like Kiana just gave up on using the Void powers and drew power from another Hyasha core to fight her. That was like gigachad moment for Kiana. So through that, it's like after that, like, so they end they conclude the battle, and then Kiana accesses the Gem of Haste, because that's what happens, right? The cores can retain the memories of the previous hosts. So
mm-hmm.
even though like she wasn't the chosen host, but she was kind of like the pseudo Hyasha of the like a fire. So Kiana yeah. could still find Himeko's residual memories inside the Gem of Haste, and Himeko also confirms like the memory only lasts up till that day. So you know, she couldn't have survived past that, because she would have memory of like dropping off the bridge and everything. So I think that's also like a second confirmation, like because the memory doesn't span any further. I mean, people high on Himekopium would go like, she probably was passed out, you know, that's why it's not recording any more memory, but then like passed out all the way till the gem was disconnected. And you could try saying that, but I feel like Siren saying that, you know, well, that we killed her already, it's like confirmation,
right.
And then like her memory not spanning beyond that one day is already very telling of like, oh, she really died that day over there, that was when it was it. So it's like it really concludes it. Although, there is, like, there's talk about, like, oh, who's going to be the A-rank imaginary. There is a line. It's just one line out of many, 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 many lines. Because, like, Himeko, like, out of the six-hour stream, I think Himeko took up a good 40 minutes to an hour. There are two acts in chapter 25 that, like, focus on, like, the conversation with Himeko. So, okay, she kept saying, like, it's not really goodbye, I'll be with you, because, like, all the things you learned from us, all the things I've taught you is, like, me being with you all the way kind of thing. So that one we understand. It's not like she's gonna be able to, like, physically manifest or appear. It's just metaphorically, she's
right.
still there with you.
Right.
But she did say, like, Kiana is speaking to a memory, like a fragment of a memory, and that's why this domain is formed. So that domain where Himeko and Kiana can talk. And then she said, Himeko is saying, like, this is just like a dream, but maybe if you dream again, we can see each other. So that one line, paraphrasing by the way, but that one line kind of like gives a hint of like, okay, there's still that 1% glimmer
that
of hope.
One line is like major Himeko.
Yeah, like,
right there. Like, oh
like if you dream again, like we can see each other. Like maybe, okay, you might be the imaginary A rank. I wouldn't hold my hopes high for that.
Right.
I think like, honestly, like my choice.
As you were telling me about that, the last couple of lines that could hint at the possibility. Like, what if it was Himeko's body, but now it's a different consciousness within. Like, I don't even know if that would even resonate well.
Okay, the only possibility of that. No. I don't think so. Okay, because I was gonna say the only possibility of that is that the Gem of Haste had the will of the previous Hyasha, a fire.
Which would have been the previous era.
Yeah. So then like. That would, like, if it took over the body of, like, Himeko. But it seems like all the personalities of the Hyashas are linked to the core. So, the core being the gem,
right.
It's already... I don't think it's possible. I think Himeko is confirmed dead this time, for sure. I don't think there is...
Especially with this scene right here.
Yeah.
Like, she's fading away.
I think, like, with Chapter 25, they really seal it. Like, I don't know how anyone could spin... It would be interesting, right? Maybe someone comes up with a theory video, how Himeko is still alive, but I honestly don't think so. I think she is... You know, she's...
I think at this point, like, if she does come back, it would only be as a Bubble Universe SP suit, right?
Yeah, yeah. I would accept that. I think, like, everyone would accept that, because they're already building, like, the Bubble Universe of, like, there's Delta, there's Kasumi, there is Struga Kongming, and there is Hexer... There's Bronny, right? So they all have to take up a different name. Kasumi can't be Sakura, like, Bronny can't be Bronya. Delta isn't Rosalia, they call her Delta. And then, like... Even Theresa is not called Theresa, so I don't know. He may something. Himekopium will come back.
Himekopium will come back as an SP suit.
My name's Himekopium. I think she is confirmed. Like, her story is closed, and people have to move on. Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty thematic too, because like. The whole one of the major themes. I don't think a whole theme, but one of the major themes of the cinematic and of this story arc is like moving forward, right?
Yeah, it is.
So
it is, because also now that you like bring that up, like throughout the story, Himeko kept saying that, you know, you have to move forward. Like that scene where you like where she has that one line, it's like it's that entire mission, there's no combat. It's just walking with Himeko on a bridge, and then they talk. Like, there's just so much exposition. And Himeko, like, Kiana at one point, like, kind of refuses to leave. And Himeko is like, but you have to move forward. And then Kiana is like, yeah, but if I stay here, we can stay here forever, because time doesn't flow here. So there's, like, there's a lot of talk about, like, but no, you have to move forward, you know, So I think like they've all completed their arc, and I'm very excited to see like what comes next, because after Lament of the Fallen, it was bittersweet for Lament of the Fallen, because I didn't really entirely agree with that move story-wise, but they do address it in Chapter 25, because Mei says something about like when she is in a conversation with the Hash of Domination, she says something about yeah, that wasn't the best goodbye, and in retrospect, we could have done it better. I don't know if that's like a fourth wall breaking developer to player moment of like, in retrospect, we could have done it better, but Mei says that exact line. So like, that for me, Lament of the Fallen was like bittersweet. I liked it for the animation and stuff, but like, I didn't really agree with it 100% story-wise. And then like, I did a 3-hour stream to talk about it right after. and like I think quite a bit of people agreed with me on that stream, but you know, we still felt that like it's good where they took it. It's just like that one part is like, oh, you're kind of like hastily driving the story in that one direction instead of like getting there.
Yeah, I mean, it's like not to go back to those old Naruto comparisons, but that's when Sasuke leaves the village, right?
Yeah, like, but.
And now we're just waiting for the time skip, but now we finally arrived we're at the time skip Kiana now.
But like for Sasuke, it was already, they were building it up for a long time. For Mei, it was like, so even up to the moment she met Kevin, she was still like Mei. And then like in that 1 second, she's like,
she was on the fence. Yeah, she was very much on the fence about it.
So it wasn't like there was like, we didn't see like pouty Mei, edgy Mei for like a long time, and then like, you know, like Sasuke was like edgy Sasuke for a long time, and he was like, okay, I snap, I go over.
That makes sense. I feel like up to this point, anybody who started playing just from the game only and didn't read the back material probably wouldn't have even known about like the Hersher consciousness within Mei's core she had to suppress, right?
That's the thing.
I think it comes up like one time in like the first chapter.
Now,
at the end of the first chapter.
Yeah, there's a lot to like take in, and I remember in the preview, the 28-second preview of this very short, I saw a comment of like, I'm sorry, I'm new to the game. Who is Murata Himeko, and what, like, why is like everyone, you know, so attached to her? And then all the replies or like, oh, prepare your tissues, like, oh, you're in for tears, like, oh, you're gonna, you know, it's gonna get dark, and like, people spamming replies on that guy. So I kind of thought, like, now that I have you guys, because I'm not the best lore-wise, like, you know, like, I'm, in a sense, good with lore, but I'm also, like, I'm the kind who, like, wants to know every little nook and cranny of everything, and, like, I want, right. I don't really like it when, like, in the comments it's like, no, but you're wrong on this, and then I go do my research and I was actually wrong on that. So, it's just, it's not anything personal against the people who comment that, it's just like, I feel like I didn't do my homework, and I shouldn't be doing a video if I didn't do that, right? So, but again, people make mistakes, so, I feel like now that I have you guys, like, I should start doing, like, lore videos, because there's also, like, a huge influx of, like, people taking up Honkai, so they can get caught up, like, just start, like, oh, from the start of, like, try see how much I can do, like, in a 10-minute, maybe 10-15-minute video, and, like, how much the story, and then, like, do it in little chapters. I had the intention of doing it way back, but, like I keep saying, the main page, the main channel, they had that one video on, like, the history of, like, Honkai, where, like, you know, like, way back, the Apocalypse family, blah, 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 and then, like, they never followed up on it.
And then here's AE.
Yeah, and they never followed up on it. I was like, oh, they got their thing going, nice, then I can also be, like, a viewer, and then, like, it'll be, and then, like, they never followed up on it. So, I do want to kind of do, but I want to, like, do another video that maybe, yeah, it's probably just, like, the stories, like, but it'll be all-encompassing of, like, manga, so that people don't have to, like, grab all the, like, you know, we'll be the ones doing it for you. Like, we'll put it, like, in the manga, like, it starts here. Because I think the story starts more from the manga than actually in the game. So it's, like,
right,
actually, yeah, just put everything together so people also get, like, better context on. Because for me, personally, like, story was fragmented for me when I started. First of all, we didn't have a lot of, like, we had a lot of remakes of the past stages. And then we had more...
I think chapters 1 and 3 got the most remake.
Yeah.
Right.
And there was also, like, they made the game more RPG-esque. But because previously it was, like, every stage had an easy, medium, hard. Or easy, hard, extreme, I think was the difficulty. Easy, hard, extreme for, every stage. It was good crystal-wise, though, because we got a lot of rewards. Like, if there's 15 stages, you're gonna get 45 stages worth of 15 crystals, which is crazy.
Right.
And then some stages, we get, like, 10 crystals per reward, so it's, like, 30 crystals for one stage. So, yeah, I guess older players are rewarded that way, but newer players also have, like, new player bonuses, so don't go being salty about that, new players. But,
And new players can still do the expedition stages for those crystals.
Yeah.
So how do you feel about this whole story arc? Because I felt like you were saying before, right? Thunder's over Nagazora when Mei assumed the Herrscher of Thunder powers. The switch from pre-Herrscher of Thunder Mei to post-Herrscher of Thunder Mei was very abrupt.
Yeah,
and
it
then
was.
For me personally, I felt like every story arc after that, Coral City, felt like a filler episode. Personally,
what did they do? No, Coral City was like building up
it
to
was major,
how they
it was
got
major,
access to the Sea of Quanta. Right, that was Coral City, right?
Well, Coral City was Rhymestar, leading up to Rhymestar and Al. And,
oh,
like,
Coral City. Okay, my bad. I thought about the underwater city.
In the context of the story, it was like, it was cool exposition-wise, because now we get to see, you know, all these, like, crazy fights, and there was a lot of action going on.
Uh-huh.
But, and it was cool from the meta sense, like, oh, we get Ana craftable G3 sticks.
That is true.
But for me, from a story sense, like, it just felt like a filler episode, aside from the exposition. Like, we got to see, Mei and Durandal teaming up, and, you know, like, okay, this is
that
a team-up
cool
episode. At first, we're kind of, like, we're kind of rival factions now.
Yeah. I mean, I enjoyed the banter between Vita and Mei. Like, they're always at each other's throats, and, like, Yeah, so...
But now, like, I feel like Mei actually has power to back up her trash-talking
yeah.
this time.
Yeah, Mei is like, definitely stronger than Rita. Kinda, like... But if anything, I always thought, like, Rita would be able to inherit Ahasha core, just because of how powerful her and Durandal are. Like...
Right, right.
Fundamentally, they're, like, insanely powerful.
It was
powerful.
Very much, like, in the earlier chapters, it was hinted that, like, Rita was, like,
yeah.
she's, like, a hidden S-rank that pretends to be an A-rank to keep
yeah.
herself uncovered.
But now she's, like,
and...
full-blown S-rank already.
Yeah.
It feels like they were, like, the answer to when Ahasha appears, so mm-hmm. that's, like, their power level, which is insanely
yeah.
powerful.
That was another situation that I thought was really cool, is because now we actually get to see BKE in storyline action, and she was even challenging Mei, like, are
yeah.
you gonna have the guts to kill Rhymestar, even though knowing, you know, there's humans behind, or, you know, they
oh.
used to be human.
Yeah.
Because that was, like, that was one of the challenges that she posed, knowing that Mei accepted the Hersher powers.
No, now that
she was willing to, in a sense, right?
Like, okay, I mean, now that we're, like, talking about that part of the story, it's also, like, it reminded me of, like, if people, because Durandal has very mixed reception in the community. It's, like, I think
right,
meta-wise,
right.
people, half dislike her and half like are okay with her. I don't think there's many like her. It's just okay with her or dislike her, meta wise, right? But story wise, now
right.
that I think about it, people might also dislike her because she was. But that's also kind of double standards because Rita doesn't get that kind of hate in any way. And then Rita was also like part of the Schicksal. She was working for Otto,
mm-hmm.
and like. I just kind of drew a bit of a connection, which might not even mean anything, but like, Durandal didn't take action against the Ahasha of the Void because of Otto's orders. So didn't, I mean, mm-hmm. Rita didn't either, right? So, now that I think,
right.
I don't think people blame her for, like, Himeko's death, but it was part of the story anyway. But it's like, when I just said that they seem to be the answer to when Ahasha appears, it felt... like Durandal's presence there was Otto's insurance policy. It's like if
yeah.
the Ash of the Void gets out of control, you're here to control her, which
right.
also speaks to how powerful she actually is. Like I don't think at this
yeah.
point we've seen Durandal show her power. I know it seems like she's not as strong as like I'm saying because when Sentience came out, Sentience like took down King and Queen in that
yeah.
animated short, but also it's like it's just one scene. We haven't seen Durandal
right.
actually react to it yet.
Yeah, we've actually never seen like Dea Ancora manifested in the main story.
Yeah, and that's supposed to be
right.
her true power. And like she didn't use a whole
bunch.
And
again, I mentioned this before. It was like, man, they could have really used the Rhymestar fight to showcase Dea Ancora.
Yeah,
and
I think
then
they're...
make it formally the signature fight like it is in the competitive side.
I honestly think the next arc is going to be focused on Rita and Durandal. Because even Himeko says something about, because Himeko, before Kiana leaves, she said, because she told Kiana something about, like, her experiences when she first joined being a Valkyrie, and, that her team leader was Ragna, and then
yeah, yeah, yeah.
she found Ragna's will, like, hidden in a book or something, and then, like, the will did say something like, if you're reading this, I'm probably dead, you know, like, that kind of...
Right, right.
Yeah, so, and then before Kiana leaves, she told Kiana, oh, you know, now that I recall, Ragna was also the teacher of Rita and Durandal. If you meet them, please remember to convey Ragna's will to them as well, because the will was, like, for her comrades, for people, you know, everyone she thinks of as, like, a,
Yeah,
like, fighting companion. So she was like, oh, convey it to Durandal and Rita. And Kiana says, I will. So it's like, it feels like that's also kind of foreshadowing, like, Durandal and Rita will be coming back into the story in some way. I feel like they might take center stage because it's also like...
I hope so. It's their turn, right? Because their last appearance was during Coral City.
Yeah.
And then they were basically put out of commission during the...
Because it seems like Durandal is right now kind of like the
She's the de facto leader of Shixul right now.
It sounds so much like Jean. It sounds so much like Jean from Genshin, who's like acting
grandmaster.
Yeah. And then like Durandal is like acting grandmaster, acting overseer of like Shixul. Oh my god, the parallels. But yeah, she's essentially Jean in Honkai right now. Which is also interesting, right? Because we know Theresa becomes the overseer. So it's like, mm-hmm. we will have that entire arc of Durandal giving up the powers of like the overseer.
Yeah,
and like eventually, handing it over to Theresa. So I feel like we're about at that stage. Also, like on hash accounts, how far are we? One, two. One is void, two is reason, three is thunder. Four is wind. Five?
Wendy, yeah.
Five is Rhymestar.
Rhymestar, but Rhymestar is technically two because Herrscher of gravity, right?
Yeah.
Herrscher of the stars.
But let's go in order first. So like five is Rhymestar, six is
Haste should be seven.
Eight is Sentience. Nine is Jesus, what's nine? Oh, nine is Star. Nine is Star of Eden. Star of Eden. So gravity. I mean, rock?
So that was Owl.
I don't remember. Yeah,
that was Owl.
So that was Owl, so that was done as well. Wait, I can't believe we don't know 6. And then 10, so 8, 9, 10. 10
Wait,
is.
Wasn't 6?
10 is Domination. 11,
okay, 10 is Domination.
11 is Binding. 12 is Corruption. What did I say 7 was?
7 is Fire. 6 is Death. Herrscher of Death.
Oh, 6 is Death. Oh, God. Oh, God. I forgot. I totally forgot. So Death hasn't appeared. I have a list of all the Hashas. Let's see if they're...
Well, see, and that's the thing that I'm really confused about, and it might not even be relevant.
Oh, 13 hasn't been revealed. So there's 13 of them, and then 14 is the end.
Yeah, so, like, I know there were some controversial ones from Gungirl Zed, and I don't know, like, how many they'll actually bring forward into Honkai.
So
I think supposedly there was, like... Yeah.
There's four more, and one of them is a mystery one. Ooh, interesting.
Yeah.
I remember, like, before Sentience was revealed, we had quite a few mystery ones, and then when they revealed it to be Sentience, it was like, oh, wow, okay. So that's interesting. Yeah, so Hyasha-wise, we are lacking four of them before the end. And if they do a 2-for-1, they're gonna end it even faster. I wonder how long more. I think... They might end it next year, honestly. Next year...
And then I can finally be set free.
I mean, I think, like, maybe next year. I don't know. Like, because they already mentioned that they have plans beyond that. So, like,
right.
I am interested to see everything, like, even all the way until the hash of the end. But, of course, they should take their time so we can, like, you know, watch every moment of it. But... And yeah, so I am really excited to see like how the story will develop past this. But story wise,
I'm very curious, like how if they're continuing the Captainverse storyline, like whether or not Captainverse will eventually, in some way, actually affect the mainline story. Because I know thus far it's kind of been its own separate imaginary storyline, or I guess it's like a parallel universe storyline, right? And they've used it as a vehicle to introduce like what if scenarios for different characters, which I've been enjoying. I know most I want to say most people have been enjoying.
I have.
It's also like, I do get the sense that like whenever there is a Captainverse storyline, you know, some people are also like, oh, but I want to get back to the main storyline and find out what happens next.
So after after Brawny, because Delta kind of like was kind of starting it for me. I honestly tuned out for like. Some of the Captainverse storylines because like it was really goofy, but like sometimes when you don't have time to keep up with the game, it kind of felt like, oh, it's your moment to goof off, you know? So it's like, it's not really
episodes.
And then now we find out it's like not canon, but it's its own canon, which is kind of like it got me interested again. So it's like, oh, so Captainverse is going to have like its own canonical own arc. I do wonder if like at any point it will cross over into the actual story. It will be really interesting to see like Theresa meet up with like Zhuge Kongming and then like Brawny and Bronya, and then like, I mean, Sakura's already dead, so that one I don't know how that would happen, but
well, I thought the Sanka saga was actually super interesting, right?
Yeah.
Because like, you find out that Callan had been forcing herself to stay alive all those years, and it almost felt like it could have been canon, because in the end of Sanka saga, Jizo, it was like Callan going into Quanta space with the Jizo sword. And like, you know, weird stuff happens in the Quanta space.
Okay. So I mean, like, that's
they could almost set up for like an SP Callan in the future.
I'm gonna put a pin
in it.
And then, you know, we're gonna have a lot of like, I'm gonna ask poke you guys for a lot of information. So I think moving forward, I'm gonna do the main storyline, like episodes of like, oh, the story of Honkai Impact, and then like, you know, moving forward. And then maybe we'll do like videos for each specific characters, like, oh, the story of Himeko, because Himeko's chapter is closed. So it's like easy to like not leave it open ended. And then I'm thinking I also want to do like a story like on the Captain Verse. Though like pulling up shots from that might be a little hard, but I guess with you guys helping out and like with YouTube people posting stuff there, or like I could even ask my community for like, oh, did you record, you know, CGs or stuff like that? I'm sure I have a lot of recordings of those too. Okay, so let's close up with like back to when we were talking
back
about, because we kind of digress from when you were asking about like comparison of like May's sudden change into the Hashira Thunder to Kiana's actual development. I think this one has been foreshadowed for a very long time, and they've been they address.
I feel like the build up was very good,
and
because it's like ever since Coral City, right? Ever since Coral City, the whole Hashira of Sentience arc, a lot of it was like exposition for Fu Hua.
Yeah,
but it wasn't really. But it was still focused on Kiana's progression, right? Like,
yeah,
we got to see Kiana's development. You know, spending time in the Samsara space with Fu Hua, in the Fenghuang Down space.
Yeah.
All that time. Basically, it was like, do you remember like the EX stages from chapter 13? Where she had like all these solo challenges, and it was like training with Fu Hua and her.
Yeah,
and her brain
space.
Yeah,
I remember those.
It was like the ending of Hersher of Sentience arc was like the payoff of the training montage from chapter 13.
Yeah.
And then leading into this arc, I feel like even going at the beginning of this whole Theater of Domination arc, right? It was all about, you know, a little bit of Sele's development and her making peace on a newer level with Veliona or Dark Sele. Dark Sele.
Mm-hmm.
And then, but in that time that we see that development taking place, we can sort of see from the outside looking in that Kiana had reached some level of equilibrium that more or less we already saw most of during the fight with Hersher of Sentience.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense? And so it was kind of cool seeing that going into this into the chapter 25, so to speak, and dealing, because I know like right now I got to the end of chapter 24. And the biggest thing at the end of chapter 24 is like, all right, the last thing that you have holding you back, Kiana, is the undealt, the guilt that you haven't resolved of Himeko's death.
Which they resolve in 25. So 25 ties up a lot of loose ends. It was really, I'm really glad I did it right before the short. And I really wanted to do it because like, also really, they did a really good job at like showing a lot of the story, was showing like this entire battle without like too many spoilers, if I might.
Mm-hmm.
Like all you know is that, oh, Bronya and Fu Hua get strung up. Oh, yeah. It happens, like that happens at the very, very end of like the last story act. I think the second last, actually, because there is a really cool fight where you can get summon them as like supports. So they come out like you're doing threshold breach. It's like they don't they don't enter, but like they come out and then they help you like repel attacks or stuff like that. And like, so each of them sacrificed to help Kiana evade a certain attack.
Okay.
So like, because like Kiana almost gets hit by something and then like, almost gets hit by a drill attack, and then Fu Hua comes in and like punches it, and then she gets pulled down. And then Bronya also like helps Kiana like evade something else, and then that's why they get caught. And then you drop down and do a 1v1 fight with like that boss that we saw. But she doesn't awaken in the story. So it's like she awakens here. So yeah, so that's like, I'm also kind of excited to like go back into CN and see what's next, like if there's any other story chapter. But I feel like it's just I feel like it's just the animated short
dialogue thing.
Because they did that for the Will of the Yasha as well. Like they said releasing on this date, and then when you go back in, it's just that one button and you click on it, it plays the story. It plays the animated short. So yeah. I also felt like because Himeko's like the guilt of Himeko being killed back then was like, it's been the main plot point of like everything that Kiana has gone through up until now.
I think even at the beginning of chapter 13, right? I guess it was it chapter 12 EX chapter?
Yeah, it kind of started this entire arc. So this ends it all. And then now all we'll like have to see for like the whole band to be back together, of course, besides Himeko, is for Mei to get back with this bunch instead of like staying with the World Serpent. So that's gonna be interesting to see as well.
I'm very curious about what comes next. Like, I know you mentioned Durandal and Rita being probably the stars of the next arc, and I'm looking forward to that. I'm very curious if they'll ever reveal the fact that Kevin has Siegfried and Ryoma in custody.
Oh!
I remember that came up in one of the later mangas, but I think they escaped because the facility they were being held in got attacked by Honkai.
Oh my god, that would be such a scene again of like Siegfried seeing Kiana now, because that's also part of like chapter 25. Siren told Kiana the reason why Siegfried sent her away. She also did tell Kiana that Siegfried didn't die. So it's like it's canon that Siegfried is still alive.
Yeah, and what I'm really curious of is if they'll ever do a reunion with Mei and Ryoma in the main storyline.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, during Evangelion, we got to see Ryoma, and he's...
That was funny. That was just for parody's sake. But
parody's sake, but, like...
So, Siren did tell Kiana that the reason why Siegfried couldn't take care of her is because Siren has deep hatred for Siegfried, because she blamed Siegfried for her own death and Bella's death. So, she said that day when she awoke is because... the Hiasha Corps reacted to Siren's hatred. So Siren said that like Siegfried was a trigger to reawakening the Hiasha powers. So that's why like Siegfried knew that. So he couldn't take care of her because like, and I made that joke on stream. It's like, imagine that. It's like every day would be, oh, I have to fight off the Hiasha of the Void. And then, okay, we go to bed, you're Kiana again. And the next day it's like, no, Siegfried. And then they fight all over. And then at night it's like, okay, you go to bed, Kiana. It's like, oh, I can't take this, man. So they had to do that. Siegfried lost an arm, but they did. But Siren confirmed that he's not dead.
Siegfried lost an arm, but I think in the manga they show him regrowing it using
the Honkai powers. Genes. Yeah. I'm wondering, like, of the four remaining Hiashas, how many cores of those does Kevin have his hands on? They might, like, reveal later on that, or has he even captured a life Hiasha that not even Mei doesn't know about, because Mei is a fairly new member of the World Serpent anyway.
Right. She might not. She's basically enforcer. She's not like actually on the organizational plan.
Yeah. So like Jackal would know, Kevin would know, but like most people wouldn't. Like even Raven wouldn't, because she's also like just a mercenary.
She's very much like, you know, I'll need to whatever's on.
It's just the job kind of a thing.
Yeah.
Because like I'll be honest, right? I do agree kind of like with like Coral City. Owl was like came out of nowhere having a Hiasha core, And he had a hashtag core for like 1 second, and that was it for him. And it's like, so the most anticlimactic hashtag in the history of Honkai is Owl.
Yeah. Even more than Wendy, right? Because like, at least Wendy, she got to hang on to it for a chapter and a half.
Yeah, she got her whole crazy arc, and that was when like Kiana and all of them were still B rank, C rank Valkyries. So it was like, there was that power level difference. It was such a intense moment. But like when Owl came out, it was like, you're already dealing with Durandal and the Hashel Thunder, a fully controlled
like,
Hashel Corp
luck,
by May. Yeah, it's like, what do you hope
luck,
you achieve with that? You're just awakened. Like, so he was like, jeez, they done him dirty, man. It's like, Owl, rest in peace. But so I'm just wondering, like, what does Kevin have under his sleeve? There might be so much more to be revealed that we still don't know about. Oh, there's just so much to unpack. But yeah, like you, I'm really looking forward to whatever is coming up after this story arc. I'm super excited for it. I really do hope it's a Durandal Rita. But I don't know how the general public would feel. I would love to see the comments on that.
I would be very interested to see an arc revolving around them investigating Otto on some level, right? Because Otto has technically been MIA since the Hersher of Sentience arc.
That is true.
So obviously he has his backup clone system type of, you know, self-regen, self-immortality protocol and whatnot, but like, I wonder if there's going to be like some type of internal conflict that would force them to try to oust Otto, and then like maybe they would have to leverage whatever peculiar alliance they have currently with AE and Serpent.
Oh,
I don't know. I'm speculating, but it's a possibility, right?
The political arc, like Attack on Titan season 2. Oh, I would love that. Like, people said, like, Attack on Titan slowed down in Season 2 because they didn't like all the politics things. I love those kinds of arcs.
And
I find it really
it
interesting.
It might also be a gateway to look at the internal politics of World Serpent, too. And maybe that could be one avenue that might be made to rejoin the main group.
Yeah, because World Serpent has been, like, we know the least about it. Like, AE right now is, like, pretty much opened up because Vault came back and, like, you know, they're all friends with that faction out of the Schicksal.
Yeah, the
and
same
then like
Freya,
Schicksal,
the same
yeah,
faction.
And like Schicksal is also mainly friendly already because like Durandal has been like, you know, they're not
he's very,
they're on good terms with like most of the other Valkyries, and like so even Kiana is like, when Himeko told her like, oh, please relay this message to like Rita and Durandal, Kiana was totally fine with it. She was like, yeah,
and visit them. Yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, Himeko did say like, if you bump into them again, but I mean, I feel like that
hopefully sooner than later. Right? That's like a good foreshadowing.
Yeah. No, one really interesting detail is like her eyes respond to the core that she takes on.
She's sharing with,
which is like, you know, it's always like, oh, the eye reveal. She had so many eye reveals this time. And it shows, like, the red eye is the active core that's being used. So you see, like, she has her own, like, void. No, yeah. So the left eye currently is, like, the one using the Hash of Reason's powers. And it is, like, oh, it reveals, like, which power she's using right now.
Yeah.
Kind of insane. Yeah. So that's really cool. I can't wait for like people to be getting to like chapter 25. There was so much. I would also like to see the like official translation. Okay, I mean, not a lot of people like reading like the English text because there's always a lot of like typos. Even in the Honkai X Genshin, we found a few typos on the first playthrough, and I'm gonna have to report them. I already reported them actually. I mean, I'm looking forward to the actual like reading it. Like, just see how they interpret it, because there were parts in, like, when I was doing the stream, because it's in Mandarin, where I even found myself, like, just paraphrasing and, like, skipping a bit of the nuances, because You know, sometimes in, like, Mandarin is, like, one sentence, but you really, there's no other way to translate it, and it'll, like, be an entire paragraph if you want to translate it into English, so I wonder how to get past that. Like, right on the fly, I couldn't do that. Maybe if I had time to, like, write it down, probably, but, that was, there's, like, so much, but it was still fun. We had, people on stream were, like, really invested in the story. Like, chat wasn't moving for a while, and then I was like, you know, but when we got to some scenes, they're like, oh, and I was like, oh, everyone's still here. Okay. Okay. So there were a lot of fun moments. And it's such a journey. I mean, we spent, not including the Honkai extension, we spent like 5 hours on it. So, there's a lot. So yeah, thank you for doing this with me again. I'm sure there's a lot more. Yeah, I'm sure there's a lot more that we'll be doing in future. And like, I look forward to be doing like the lore videos. A lot of it's going to be really basic initially of like, oh, here's the story of Honkai. It's going to be like, I hope it's going to be like easy to digest for people just taking up Honkai and like they're so lost in the story, but they want to know more. That would be the objective for it. Because when I also when I stopped wanting to do it, I thought like, oh, Honkai's player base has pretty much like it's there already, so like people who wanted the story already know the story. But having seen that funny comment on like, who's Humurata Himeko and like why is everyone so attached to her, I'm like, okay, probably a video like that is warranted, you know. So yeah, that would also be a lot of fun. And I'll be getting a lot of help from you guys, like, you know, Zkodla, maybe sometimes UD, because like they are so super invested in the story. They do like they do like manga streams, they do like just entire story streams. So like I'm sure I'm gonna need a lot of help from them. But you as well, because like surprisingly, like your lore, because I thought you were more gameplay centric, but like lore wise you're also like, I would say I don't know if like it's more extensive than me, but like probably. So I'll be getting
bits and pieces. There's, you know, like,
yeah,
I've read a couple of wikis. I've done some research, and
I read up
bits and pieces from the manga. You know,
I read up a lot on the Divine Keys. I remember on the Chinese sites, of people who have like entire like documentaries on them. So like I was at one point, I was so confused, like what the heck is a divine key? Like if it contains a hasha core and only one of the type of like, you know, like if it's void and then like how can two cores exist? Like I thought. And then I was like, oh, divine keys are like past civilization cores, and it's like, wow, there's so much to understand when it comes to Honkai. So like I'm gonna be really excited moving forward doing those. I hope I can fit those into a schedule, and like we're probably gonna talk a lot regarding all of those, and it, like any other shorts or stuff like that in future. Like I hope we can also be doing it. Maybe we'll add more people, who knows? But it's also gonna be interesting because like we don't add like Kotla because she's also like she has her own reaction video. So like I don't wanna like get in the way of that, right? And then like if you eventually want to do your own, like, well, I'll start doing this solo. Like, so but like if there are more people who like want to be in it, but yeah, I think like it'd be nice to have like a conversation. I don't think timing wise we could do a stream. That's why we do it in a video, because like it's gonna be weird.
It's like super
late at night. It's totally not in like any of our stream schedules, so it's like we kind of like take time off to do it. So it's gonna remain in video format, but like I really appreciate like you taking time out to like do this with me, and I hope to do more of it. So any comments you guys have, leave it in the comments. It's gonna be really fun. You can find Fenrysk on twitch.tv/Fenrysk. I also have a Twitch, so you can check our links in the description. And we'll see you guys soon.
And we're also on HoYoLAB.
Oh, yes.
To look up our stuff on HoYoLAB.
Yes, HoYoLAB. I'll leave our IDs in the description as well. Go drop us a follow.
I've been reposting some old fan art, and I've been making some of my videos. So.
Yeah, I wanted.
Actually, they followed me back. I was so surprised.
Yeah. Wait, who?
X-Fate.
Oh.
One of the top fan artists for Honkai.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
I was
yeah.
super surprised.
That's cool. So, yeah. We'll leave our IDs. You guys can check it out. Hang on. My dog's going crazy. Yeah. And then, I meant to do that, so thanks for reminding me, because I totally forgot about it. But yeah, so that's all we have for today. And I hope to see your comments. Yep, bye-bye, guys.
Bye-bye.